are you doing here?
Just preparing yourself, Stephen's governor's orders. I'll take that bed on your right. Okay.
What happened to the things in my locker?
Oh, Mrs. Morris took them.
Hello, Parker. You ready for dinner? Well, the rest of the ladies are gone down.
Oh, Colleen, the police are in reception. They're asking for you.
For me? My God. She must have found them.
Come on, Parker. I'm not going to hurt you. Hey?
No, you stay away from me.
Cass. Now, Cass, it's all right. Come on, love. Settle down. Settle down. I'll see that she gets to the dining room, okay?
Look, I'm sorry. I thought I could show her she had nothing to be afraid of. Parker, I'm sorry.
Yes. He didn't mean to frighten you. Yeah.
You'll stay with me, but won't you, Min?
Don't worry, dear, I will. Yeah. Now, let's go and get our tea.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
Hello, Inspector. Stay, please, Min.
Sorry to trouble you at this time of the day, Mrs. Powell, but we've had information that one of your officers might be able to help us in our inquiries into a hit and run.
What have you been told?
Well, a witness said that he saw a woman in what looked like a prison officer's uniform near where the victim was found.
I'm glad you're here, Inspector. I was just about to come and see you myself.
About the accident?
Yes. I was driving the car that hit that man.
Yes, yes. All right, I'll tell her first thing in the morning. Thank you. Oh, off the date.
Yep.
Oh, half your luck. What are the police doing here? They didn't even ask to speak to the governor, just wanted to see Mrs. Powell.
There now. Maybe I better stick around for a while, just in case I'm needed.
Hello, Mr. Manning. Getting a hang of the place?
I still need a map to find my way around. Other than that, no worries. Well, apart from Parker.
What about Parker?
I don't think it's anything serious. She just gets scared stupid every time she claps eyes on me.
Wouldn't take that too lightly. She decapitated our last male officer.
Yeah, so I heard. But from what I understand, it was a clear case of self-defence.
Oh, that's her story. If you ask me, we'd all be a lot safer if she were put away in an asylum for the criminally insane.
I'm sure you know these ladies better than I do, Miss Ferguson, but... don't you think that's a bit heavy? I mean, what Parker's been through, she's bound to be shaky for a while.
These women don't need sympathy, Mr. Manning. But no doubt you'll find that out in time. The hard way.
Well, that's all I can tell you, Inspector. Except to say that I had no reason to believe that he was hurt.
Well, thank you for being so honest, Mrs. Powell. Now, if we can just find a witness to corroborate what you've told us.
Yes, there is a witness.
The prison officer we've been told about.
The whole incident was seen by our acting deputy governor, Joan Ferguson. Meg, would you see if she's still here, please?
Yes, of course.
Hello, Belinda.
What do you want?
I know you had it fixed to be put in with Sonia, and I have a pretty good idea why.
Maybe you.
Belinda, don't you realise that if anything happens to Sonia after lockup, there is no way you'll get away with it?
Listen, Bryant, I'm getting pretty sick of telling you. Just whack off or start making life really unpleasant. Are you going to move, or am I?
Okay. But you should think about what I've said to you. Hurting Sonia is not worth spending the rest of your life in this dump for.
How shall we dance?
I'm choosy with my partners.
Well, that's not what I read on the dunny walls.
I hear you're top dog now.
So?
So perhaps you tried to get rid of the competition by stabbing me in the back.
Oh, God.
Literally.
Sorry, Inspector. There's nothing more I can tell you.
You didn't see Mrs. Powell at all?
No.
Well, then why would Mrs. Powell call on you to corroborate her account of the accident?
Well, she must have misunderstood me. I didn't see the accident at all. When I arrived at the scene, the man was already dead.
Why didn't you stay and talk to the police?
Oh, I didn't think it was necessary. There was a man there already with the body when I arrived, and there didn't seem to be any more that I could do to help.
Yeah. Right. Well then, Mrs. Powell, we'll have to ask you to accompany us to the station. We'll need a formal statement.
All right. Sorry I wasted your time, Miss Ferguson.
That's all right, Mrs. Powell. Just wish I could have been of more help.
Bobbie, it's your turn.
Bloody cards. I wish they'd bring the telly back. It's boring with nothing to do.
Yeah, I miss the cartoons.
Where's your Superman comic, dear?
I don't know. I suppose Phyllis must still be reading it.
Yeah, that'd be right. It'd take her that long.
Yeah,
I noticed Belinda didn't take too kindly to your suggestion.
That's an understatement. From what you told me, you don't know why you bothered. Sonia had been no loss.
She killed Sonia. She'd be inside for years.
So what? Her life's not worth much anyway, being blind.
No, I wouldn't like being blind.
Me neither.
For heaven's sake, listen to the two of you. You'd think it was the end of the world because you lose one of your faculties.
Yeah, I reckon you might be right there, Min. There's a few around here without a brain. They don't seem to worry.
No, dear, that's why you're getting on so well.
Anyway, you're missing the point, love. If there's any more trouble around here, we're going to be the ones that suffer.
You're suffering already.
Any ideas how to stop it, though, Judy?
Not really, unless we put a tail on her. At least we're following her constantly. She can't get up to any more trouble. I'm out.
It should be easy. I mean, we could all take turns.
Well, I'll be in that, Jude. Anything beats sitting around here all day.
Oh, but you've got to finish the game first. Wouldn't be fair to stop now. Min's got four kings.
Yes, you're not supposed to tell people what you've got.
Oh, my God.
Hey, hang on a minute. Belinda's leaving. Do you want me to follow her?
No. You let her get a bit of a head start, and then you stay well behind. Don't get seen or you'll blow it, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, Mrs. Powell.
Do I have to be here much longer?
Could be a while. We're checking out the possibility of another witness.
Someone who saw it all?
Well, you hope so. The fellow who stayed with the body said there was a young bloke there as well. Reckon he didn't want to be involved with the coppers.
Well, wouldn't have hurt him to make a statement.
Well, maybe it would. Could be he's known to us for other matters.
So, what's likely to happen now to me?
Oh, it doesn't look likely we'll be laying any charges at this stage.
Thank God.
Depends what this witness has got to say when we find him. You didn't see anyone in the vicinity?
Not that I can remember.
Well, the other witness is looking at the mugshots now. If he comes up with this guy he saw, I'll give you a look. It might jog your memory.
Yeah, well, I hope to God it does. I'm not exactly what you'd call sitting pretty, am I?
Don't worry. There must be someone who saw what happened. If there was, we'll find it.
Thanks, Inspector. Oh, can I try my husband again?
Be my guest.
You're looking much better, Mum.
Well, I feel stronger anyway.
Good. You reckon you'll make the team by Saturday?
Might be a week or two yet.
Fresh out of somebody's garden. Pinched him on the way over.
Have you any idea what's happening at Wentworth?
No, and you shouldn't be worried about it either.
The papers say there's still trouble at the prison, but they don't say what it is. Nobody seems to want to tell me.
Well, did you ask Mrs. Powell when she came in?
Yes, but she fobbed me off. Probably wanted to stop me worrying. I wish people had realised it can be worse not knowing.
Look, stop worrying about work. Concentrate on getting better.
If one more person says that to me, I think I'll scream.
Okay, okay.
I'm sorry. But I'm not going to stop worrying till I get some straight answers.
Well, can I help?
I don't know. Wait a minute, one of those books belongs to Colleen.
Which one?
The one with the yellow edge. Why don't you return it for me and see what you can find out?
Right.
Now about telling me why you're so edgy.
Me? I'm okay. Well, I gotta look like I'm worried about you, don't I? Well, I'll just give these back to the nurse. Put some water with them before they cark it.
Who's there? I know somebody's there. Who is it? Stuff them.
Did I hear you suggesting an act of physical gratification to someone, Belinda?
Just some turd following me.
Mitchell, what are you doing?
Nothing much. Let's do something about it.
Yeah, let's. It's almost luck up time, so you can get yourself off to yourself.
By myself? Oh, well, it was worth a try.
You officer talking to Mitchell?
Yeah, I thought it was that bitch Bryant.
Huh? What's she done to make you so aggressive?
Oh, nothing much. Just don't trust her, that's all.
She's no friend of mine either. We should make up a team. I'm sure the women would think being blind would make you quite harmless. I'd certainly make it worth your while if you hear anything that I should know.
Sounds good. Reckon I struck it lucky getting in here with you.
Hello? How did you know I was still here?
Well, I rang Patrick and he said you were working back, so I guessed you'd been held up and might need some moral support.
Well, you're not wrong there. I'm waiting to see some mug shots of someone who might have seen the whole accident.
Why didn't you tell Patrick what had happened?
Oh, couldn't do that. He's got enough worries losing his job.
Is there anything I can do?
You're doing it. Well, it wasn't much fun sitting here worrying myself stupid on my own. Thanks for coming.
It was the least I could do. You know, this could have been avoided if Joan had only told the truth.
Oh, sure.
You know, she's itching to be governor, and she doesn't care how many bodies she walks over on the way.
Well, she's done a dash as long as I've got Donovan's medical report.
Mm. I'm surprised she just didn't say she saw you hit the man and keep on going.
What, Joan? Oh, no. Too crafty for that. Besides, she wouldn't take the chance on getting a perjury charge. This way she doesn't even have to appear as a witness.
Mrs. Powell?
Yeah.
Oh, I've got something for you. Ring any bells?
No.
His name is Rod Lewis. He's been identified as the possible witness.
You're groaning. I just want to see if you're all right.
My shoulder's giving me help.
Yeah, all right. So long as you're okay.
You're walking.
Car trouble. Well, what brings you here?
My mum asked me to drop this off to Mrs. Powell. Would you mind taking it for me?
No, no worries. How is she?
She's picking up. Look, what she really wanted was for me to come down and find out how things are going here.
I'll try and get to see her later on today. The trouble with being in hospital is you've got too much time to worry about things.
Yeah, I've had to watch my step.
What?
Didn't Mum tell you I had a bit of a brush with a fellow's gang?
Oh, yes, she did tell me something about it. They're not at you again, are they?
No, it's just that I've got to go to a line-up tomorrow to identify the bloke who broke into my flat. Yeah, but don't tell her, will you?
I promise. I better be running. Bye.
And Johns and Bryant make up the laundry detail. Parker and Mitchell, kitchen duty.
You'll be able to talk to your little mate, Harry.
Yeah, he needs a good talking to.
What have you got against Harry, for heaven's sake?
He eats mice.
That's enough. Donovan, report to reception. Don't bother packing your bags, though. I'm sure you'll be back.
Don't worry about beach features. Good luck with the beacon.
Yeah, good luck,
Bobby. Keep it down, you lot. You'll all be on report.
Miss Ferguson, could I have the morning off, please?
Maybe that's why she's still alive today.
Bryce told me last night that she and Kelly were going to make a habit of it.
I should tell Sonia what's going on.
I don't know what you're planning for me next, Brian, but you'd be well advised to forget it.
Now, just a
minute. My back is well and truly covered, and don't you forget it.
Okay, everybody, move out now. Come on, move it. Donovan, get going.
I don't believe it, Mrs. Powell. Just as we're getting the press and TV people off our backs, you get yourself involved in more trouble.
I expect to be totally cleared of any charges.
Does it matter?
What do you mean?
The story will come out anyway. It'll put you in a very poor light and give us more bad publicity.
But if there are no charges laid against me, my name won't even be mentioned in the papers.
Perhaps. But I suggest you take leave of absence until the matter is completely cleared up.
If that's what you wish.
It is.
Well, before you decide on my replacement, I think you should read these reports on Officer Ferguson.
Well, Stevens, I hope this morning is a minor setback. I don't want you out of circulation for too long.
Somebody wants me out permanently.
Getting paranoid, are we?
Oh, come on. Ground glass in my hand cream, a smashed mirror and being stabbed in the back. It's hardly a Halloween trick.
All right. But who?
That's easy. Bryant. She's managed to take over as top dog. She's got most of the women on her side. And don't forget, she had the goods confiscated. I'm telling you, unless something's done soon, she'll put me out of business permanently.
All right, Stevens, leave it with me. You won't have to wait too long. Everything is looking just fine.
Let me get this straight. Miss Ferguson and the other prisoner, Shaw, were on their way with Donovan's meal. But you and Parker took over.
Yes, sir, on Mrs. Powell's instructions.
Was the meal out of your sight at any time?
Well, I did leave Parker in the cell with Donovan for a couple of minutes.
You're aware that conversation with prisoners in solitary is forbidden, aren't you?
I asked Mrs. Barfield to turn a blind eye.
Even the rules for solitary mean little, it seems. All right, thank you, Mrs. Barfield. That will be all. Send in Miss Ferguson, please.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Seems obvious to me that it was Parker who tried to poison Donovan.
I don't think so.
She'd been in the hospital for treatment. She could have stolen the necessary poison.
Donovan is her closest friend.
Miss Ferguson tells me they had a serious argument before this happened.
Not that serious.
Parker is mentally unstable. A record proves she'd need little motivation for such an action. But what really happened is quite obvious, and I can think of no good reason why an officer of Miss Ferguson's caliber should suffer these allegations. I'll do nothing about the position of acting deputy governor at this stage. The new department head can make that decision.
You sent for me, sir?
Yes, Miss Ferguson. We have a staff problem. Would you be prepared to accept the position of acting governor?
Well, if you believe it's within my capabilities, Minister, I can hardly refuse.
Rostered you for a double shift, Mrs. Murrows. We're somewhat short-staffed since Mrs. Powell was suspended.
She wasn't suspended. She's on leave of absence.
I remind you, Mrs. Murrows, you are no longer acting deputy. You're merely another officer. And you will show the same respect as the rest of the staff.
Look, if we're so pressed for staff, why don't you take the rounds on your own?
It's time you read the regulations, Mrs. Morris. The governor must be accompanied by an officer at all times. Now, let's not hold up the working day any longer, shall we? It is usual to come to attention when the governor enters a room.
When do we break out the champagne?
I'll ignore that slip this term, Smart. But any other prisoner who sees fit to criticise the department's decision will find herself on a charge. Clear? I said clear?
Yes.
Good. Now, just so you don't forget that you're under new management, I'll be introducing some new rulings. Starting with tighter security measures. There will be no more wandering around the prison unescorted as of this minute. Glad to see you taking it so well. Get back to work. Oh, Parker. I've arranged for you to have some psychiatric assessment later this week.
What does that mean? What sort of treatment is that?
The treatment comes later, Parker. This is merely to decide which mental institution would prove most suited to you.
Bitch. Oh, it's going to be a belly full of laughs having her running the joint.
Cass, she's just trying to scare you, love. There's no way you're going to go to a place like that.
You and your hotshot lawyer, they threw the bloody book at me.
Harry told me you were lucky you didn't get life after the names you called that judge.
Didn't suit so good yourself, did you? Thought they might go easy on an old bird like you.
Now, don't you use that tone with me. I wouldn't take it when you lived with me, and I'm not about to take it now.
Well, you know what? I pissed off. Maybe, bitch.
All right, cut the talk.
Maybe you wouldn't have wound up in prison if you'd stayed with the family.
No, I'd have ended up like you, would I?
No, I think this one would suit you, Miss Shrewsbury.
But I told you I wanted something much more feminine.
Oh, but it wouldn't suit you. Well, I mean, I think something more in the classic line would give you a more tailored sort of a look.
Then you're not a very good judge of what's suitable for me at all, are you? Now, this one... Heavens, it's terribly expensive. And that's not even real lace.
It most certainly is. Anyway, I don't think this would be much good because we only have it in one size.
And I'm sure I can find just what I want in another store. At half the price. And double the courtesy.
I don't think that lady will be back, Pixie.
Oh, I'm sorry. I know you can't afford to lose customers. Will you have to sack me?
Of course. Now, that was just teasing. The lady wouldn't have bought a dress anyway.
How do you know?
When you've been in the business as long as I have, you just know.
Oh, thank heavens.
And to show you how pleased I am with your work, you and I are going to have a nice lunch together. Would you like that?
I'd love to.
The department must be mad putting Ferguson in charge.
You're telling us. I don't know why they didn't bring in the bloody Gestapo and be done with it.
My sentence is going to seem twice as long now.
I'm really sorry to see you back off. What'd you get?
A year.
Oh, God, I thought your lawyer was very optimistic about getting you off.
They found out about my kids. The way the prosecution talked, you would have thought I was running a junior mafia.
Well, I'm sorry, Kim, but I'm glad you're going to be here at least till I go.
Hey, what's all this about?
I mean, Miss Ferguson's making me see a special doctor so she can put me in one of them mental places.
That's just for assessment, Cass.
Yeah, don't let it get to you, honey.
They're awful things here in them places, Min. You remember that film we'd seen a while back? I was tying people up, putting all them wires on their heads.
That's all it was, dear, a film. Anyhow, don't you worry, you're not leaving here. We'll take care of you. Won't we, Judy?
Yeah, of course we will.
Damn, just smoked my last pack of fags. Pity Pixie can't smuggle us in some goodies, isn't it?
Something 6 feet tall, male, sexy, would fill the bill nicely.
Never give up.
Attention, ladies. Whoa. This is Rebecca Kean, and I want you all to show her the ropes.
Her name's Reb. How many times have I told her?
See if she gets enough. Will you, Judy? She'll be sharing with you.
Yeah, sure.
Well, how are you, love? Come and have a seat.
Rather pretty, thanks.
She's not going to take much wet nursing, is she?
No.
Mrs. Morris, how long do we have to put up with Miss Ferguson lying the joint?
And what's happened to Mrs. Powell?
None of your business, is it?
Ooh. Oh, she's getting the rough end from Ferguson, too. That new chick already has. Still right up her nose.
I think it always has been. Poor Reb, she's got the whole chopping block on her shoulder.
Do you know her?
Yes. One of my kids bought a home last year. She thought our operation was far too juvenile for her. Told us so in very colourful words.
What's she in for, me?
Armed robbery. She got 7 years.
Oh, poor kid.
Pretty stiff sentence.
Apparently she and her accomplice really roughed up the hold-up victim. Taking the rap on her own, too. The other one got away. Silly child. She's mucked up a life before it really started.
Well, it won't take much for this place to take the sting out of her.
That's for sure.
That was the most heavenly meal, Mr. Schumann. Couldn't eat another bite or I'd burst.
I don't imagine the food at Wentworth is quite up to the standard.
No, it's not like this at all. I just wish Judy and Cass and the others could be here too.
You've made some good friends, then.
Oh, yes. Well, sometimes when I go back, I feel guilty about having such a lovely day, but they don't mind at all. They were thrilled to bits when they found out I had this job.
I'm glad you live with such nice people. Oh, I've enjoyed this very much. But now it's time. We must get back. You know what I hope people are thinking? There's a proud father taking his pretty daughter out to lunch.
Oh, what a lovely thing to say, Mr. Schumann. I've enjoyed myself so much.
Then my very wish was fulfilled. Excuse me.
On the table.
Thank you, miss. No doubt I'll be back for it.
I'm sure they will. It looks very expensive.
Thank you, sir.
I think Mrs. Reynolds is feeling a little apprehensive about her first session, but that's not unusual, is it? Mr. Slater will be giving you your physio treatment, Mrs. Reynolds. Believe me, he's the best.
I was expecting a female.
Oh, that's a switch. The patients in men's surgical are grumbling because the lady doctor's been replaced by a male. I'll leave it to you, Mr. Slater. I'm sure you'll find Mrs. Reynolds a very cooperative patient. We certainly have.
Well, let's hope you're not going to make a liar out of matron. You don't look like a prude.
I'm not.
Do you have a female doctor at the prison?
No.
Well, then I'm rather amazed at your attitude. A breast is like any other body protrusion, like an arm or a leg.
I find that extremely insensitive.
They're just the plain ordinary facts.
Yes, but it's the way you present them, Mr. Slater.
Mrs. Reynolds, I'm your physio, not your psychiatrist. Now, I do have other patients, so I suggest we stop all this silly nonsense and get on with your treatment.
And I suggest you go to your other patients. I'm sure I can find someone equally competent with some semblance of courtesy.
Matron wasn't bragging. I'm the best.
Who are you reassuring, Mr. Slater, the patient or yourself? Now, you go and rearrange your schedule. I'll make my own arrangements, thank you.
sorry, I'm late.
Miranda, I've been thinking. Maybe your mother was right. I mean, the bridegroom's not supposed to see the dress until the day.
Oh. It's gorgeous. I think I'll try that one on first.
It's unlucky, you know.
I told you I don't believe in those stupid old superstitions. Come on.
Well, I just don't want to take any chances, that's all.
Ralph, I think you're shy about going in there. It's easy to see you've never done this before. Come on.
You know, it's not like Mrs. Morris to be so tight-lipped. I wonder what is going on with Mrs. Powell.
Yeah, well, I just hope that Mrs. Reynolds comes back soon. I mean, it was only supposed to be minor surgery. They can't keep her there forever.
If you could all stop bitching for a minute, you might find time to keep the table full.
Oh, well, aren't you the little eager beaver? What will we ever do when they let you out?
I don't care if I never get out. Got no plans outside this dump.
I wouldn't make too many inside if I were you.
If I did, you wouldn't figure in them, that's for sure.
Hey, what sort of tests will they make me do, Min?
Oh, they'll probably just talk to you, love. Maybe ask you a few questions, like, how do you like it in here? That sort of thing.
Well, you don't have much to say for yourself, Becky.
The name's Reb. You piss off, you're crowding your space.
Hug me for breathing.
That sort of attitude will get you nowhere in here, Reb.
Yeah, well, I told you what you could do with your advice a long time ago.
Hello. Can I help you?
I'm just trying to decide which one of these two dresses to try on. They're both lovely, aren't they?
Well, I think you'd have to try them both on to see how heavenly they really are. I think this one would look nice on you.
Think so? I've hunted everywhere for just the right one.
I know. Everything has to be just perfect on the day, hasn't it? Would you like me to assist you?
I'll give you a call if I need any help.
All right. Well, the fitting room's just through here. There you are.
Thanks.
Can I help you or are you both together? Ralph! Well, what are you doing here?
Hello, Pixie love. I'm just helping my fiancé choose her wedding dress.
You mean... Oh, but you can't marry anyone else because you're married to me.
No, I'm not. Our marriage was declared null and void, remember?
Look, I don't care what they said. Well, we were married in a church. Well, if you marry anyone else, you'd be a bigamist.
No, Pixie, that's you. You didn't mention at the time about your first three husbands. Look, Miranda doesn't know about us. I never got around to telling her. She's a very sweet kid. She'd be very upset if she knew.
I always remember our wedding day. I'm not sure it wasn't the nicest one of all.
Well, it was wonderful, but let's keep it between us, okay?
Well, she does seem quite sweet. I'll make sure she looks just as pretty as I did when we were married. She likes the one I chose. She looked really beautiful, didn't she?
Yeah.
I hope you don't mind, Ralph, but it's very like the one I wore on our wedding day, isn't it?
What did you say?
Miranda, I can explain everything.
You were married to her. You're a divorced man, you never even bothered to tell me.
No, I'm not divorced.
What?
I mean, I was married, but I wasn't. Explain.
Well, you see, Ralph and I were married all...
I don't want to hear any more. And I hate the dress anyway.
Now do you see what you've done?
I'm sorry, Ralph. I was only trying to help.
Do me a favour. Next time, don't try and help.
But... I lived in a bit of a hurry. What happened?
I think they had a few premarital problems to sort out.
Paul? You're looking worried. Are you not still upset by the fellows gang, are you?
No, this time it's Mum. Matron said she wouldn't let the physio treat her.
Oh, that doesn't sound like it.
I know. She'll be pleased to see you, though. Listen, would you mind not mentioning about me fronting up for that identification?
No, of course not.
Do To be honest, I wish I could get out of it.
Well, at least it'll be over once and for all.
There's no way Ray Fox is going to get off the hook this time. Listen, I'm sorry I laid it on you. It's just that I needed someone to talk to.
That's okay. You're right. It's no use worrying Anne at the moment. Well, I'll try and cheer her up with some Wentworth gossip. But that's not exactly good news either.
You do think she's coming along, okay?
Yes, I do. I think it helps her knowing she's got a son who really cares.
Not much chance of hiding the crown jewels in here, Pixie.
I wish I could. Haven't got much jewellery at all.
Oh, has Mason had a body search yet, Miss Riley?
No. I'd say she's clean, Miss Ferguson.
You'll use the correct title, Miss Riley.
Yes, Governor.
Right. Complete body search. Now.
Oh, no! Well, I do have a few things, but I didn't think they'd be counted. I mean, oh, it's nothing much, is it?
You know the rules, Mason. You've broken them, you will now be charged. You'll also lose your work release. 24 hours in solitary, Miss Riley. Give her something to think about.
Is it true? She's the governor now?
Acting governor.
Paul, I am not being neurotic about this. I just need someone who understands how I feel, and I believe a woman would have more chance of doing that.
Sure, sure.
Oh, Meg, I am sorry. You put yourself out to come here, and I've done nothing but sound off since you walked in. Now, please tell me about Wentworth. I really need to know before I go totally crazy.
Well, I think you're a long way from the funny farm yet. But the news isn't good. Joan's been appointed acting governor.
Who? What prompted that?
With Colleen's leave of absence, my demotion, and Joan's spotless record with the department, she was their obvious choice.
They'll have a riot on their hands.
Well, we've already had trouble even before she was appointed. All we can do is really try and persuade the women to cooperate for their own sakes.
God, ma'am, sounds like you better get stuck into that treatment and get back there.
Paul, I know you mean well, but I've had just about enough of that bush psychiatry for one day.
I'm sorry. That bloke must have been a real drag.
That's the understatement of the year. Oh, look, I'm sorry, both of you, but I really am rather tired.
That's all right. I was going anyway. Got another shift to do tonight. Try and call in and see you soon.
Thanks, Meg. I really appreciate you coming.
Can I give you a lift back, Mrs. Morris?
Oh, thanks, Paul.
Sorry I hassled you, Mum. I just want you to get back to your old self again.
That's never quite going to happen, is it?
I know Mum was pleased you went, even if she did keep snapping our heads off.
You know what I think? She gave that physio a piece of her mind today, and it probably did her good. We just got the leftovers.
She's got to have that treatment, though.
She will. She knows that. I saw that old sparkle back in her eye today. Now, considering what she's been through, I think she's coming through very well.
She did sit up and take notice when you told her about Joan Ferguson, didn't she?
Joan's enough to put anyone on the alert. Gee, I will be glad to see you back here, though. Thanks for the lift.
Don't worry about the identification parade tomorrow. It's strictly routine.
Sure. Good night, Mrs. Morris, and don't work too hard.
First day in the laundry?
Bet I'm scrubbing dunny, suspense.
You'll get plenty of dunny duty. The freak sees to it that we all get more than our fair share of dirty work. Yeah, I guess your timing was bad coming in when she took over. Still, if we all stick together, it won't be so bad.
You can. I'll look after myself. Always have, always will.
Really? I thought you had a partner in that little job you pulled.
Look, I work with these creeps when I need them. That's where it ends.
It's your first time inside, isn't it?
Chucked me in reform school a couple of times. Guess this isn't too different.
Well, guess again, kid.
I'll take it as it comes.
I reckon she's onto me. She keeps stopping and listening.
Okay, I'll take over for a while. It'll confuse her, if nothing else.
Okay.
Well, you certainly scored well moving in with Jude. She's top dog around here.
Won't be here long. Gonna ask for a single. Don't need no favours from top dogs.
Yeah, no. The way you've been acting around here, I reckon you're doing Jude the favour.
Who's there?
Getting sick of your kids' games. I know it's you. All right, whatever turns you on. I thought it was you. God, you must have it bad. What happened? Everyone else turn you down? That's not why I'm following you, and you know it. Just get out of here. Get out of here, before I get every screw in the place running. Why can't I make you see sense? If you kill Sonia, you will be destroying your own life. Don't you realize that? Okay, maybe what I should do then is tell Sonia what you're up to. That'd be terrific, wouldn't it? You'd last 5 minutes if she knew about it.
Just get out!
Oh, you stupid bitch! How long do you think it'd take Sonia to get these off you if you ever tried it? About 2 seconds. And then she'd kill you. That, my friend, would be self-defense. She wouldn't even get the rap for killing you.
Judy!
Oh, God, Mrs. Morris. Mrs. Morris, I told her I wouldn't. I told her. She was forcing me to have sex with her.
When morning comes around.